Welcome to the Frontier Podcast, where we take the internet's best tech articles and transform them into audio so that you can enjoy them on the go. We post new episodes every Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday morning. Be sure to subscribe to our channels on YouTube and iTunes, or visit us at tfpodcast.io. If you would like to help support our show, we'd really appreciate it. Visit our Patreon and donate. All of those links will be listed below. Today's episode is brought to you by Presence Media. They are a Colorado-based SEO and web design firm. Presence Media creates beautifully modern websites that effectively attract new customers for their clients. Visit them at presencemediadenver.com. That link will be listed below. Today's article was written by Nir Eyal. Nir is a Wall Street Journal bestseller and a very insightful writer. His website, nirandfar.com, that's N-I-R-A-N-D-F-A-R.com, is about behavioral design, the art and science of helping people to get the most out of life. Nir writes to help companies create behaviors that benefit their users while educating people on how to build helpful habits in their own lives. Today's episode is titled, Three Pillars of the Most Successful Tech Products. If you'd like to read the original article, including the embedded images, you can find it on nirandfar.com. That's N-I-R-A-N-D-F-A-R.com. We'll have that link listed below. Three pillars of the most successful tech products. If you've started a tech company to make a lot of money, chances are you're bad at math, or simply delusional. Statistically speaking, your odds of a big-time payday are somewhere between zero and almost zero. 92% of startups fail within 3 years. Only 1% of apps in the App Store are financially successful. And even for a fortunate few companies that raise venture funding, 75% will fail to generate a return on investors' capital. Why do some companies scale to millions of users while others wallow in obscurity? What explains the runaway success of a company like Facebook, while a startup like Viddy, a mobile app for video, attracted millions of users and millions of dollars in financing, only to lose both? When it comes to startup success, there's never a magic bullet. Yet, as the British statistician George Box once wrote, quote, "All models are wrong, but some are useful," end quote. Perhaps the hardest part about running a new business is knowing what to prioritize. There are hundreds of decisions to make, and keeping sight of what's important and what's not is a constant challenge. But when it comes to helping teams stay focused, I have found one model to be extremely useful. It's called the GEM framework. The origin story of the framework is uncertain, but I've heard a similar model was first used during the early days of LinkedIn. A company's job is to find a sustainable way to deliver value to customers, employees, and shareholders. To do this, the company must never lose sight of its GEM. It's growth, engagement, and monetization. Growth is all about how a company finds new users or customers. Fundamentally, it's about getting the right message in front of people who need what you have. I call these messages external triggers. External triggers are delivered through various channels, including television commercials, salespeople, emails, and word of mouth. Some external triggers, like one satisfied customer telling another about your product, costs you nothing. Others, like running ads on Google or buying billboards along the highway, can cost big bucks. There's nothing inherently better or worse about one external trigger versus another. What matters is whether the trigger fits your business. Viral growth is wonderful, but difficult to engineer and sustain. Meanwhile, buying media can produce a steady stream of customer interest, but can be expensive. The growth question to answer is, are we getting better at drawing the attention of people who need our product? And quantifying the answer to that question means tracking the number of new users or customers over time, as well as the cost of earning their attention. It's important to recognize that growth is a process and a practice, not an end state. Companies satisfied with their growth strategy are at risk of losing customers to their competitors. The growth hackers I know manically look for new channels and relentlessly test how many potential customers can be found, and for what cost. Growth question. Are we getting better at drawing the attention of people who need our product? Growth metric, number of new users or customers, and the cost of finding them. Engagement. With some products and services, customer engagement is naturally infrequent. Think of the way people buy real estate or book vacation travel. Other businesses require constant, habitual engagement to survive. Apps like Facebook, Slack, Salesforce, and Snapchat need to become a habit, or else they'll go out of business. If the service isn't used often, these products become less useful, and eventually, customers never return. Retaining customers means keeping them engaged, whether they're checking in on an app or checking out a purchase. Some businesses depend on repeat customer engagement more than others. But most critical for investors, founders, and employees is to understand what brings people back. To track engagement, companies should calculate the percentage of people using their product or service frequently enough to be classified as retained. For some products, it's once a year. For others, it's once an hour. The question, are we getting better at engaging people who need our product, is answered by calculating the growth in percentage of retained customers. Engagement question, are we getting better at engaging people who need our product? Engagement metric, percentage of retained users or customers. Monetization. Finally, companies need to turn some of the value they create into cash or they go out of business. There are many ways to capture value. Companies can charge a subscription fee, sell a one-time purchase, or create marketplaces where they take a share of the transaction between buyers and sellers. When it comes to monetization, the most crucial question is, are we getting better at capturing the value we create? The metric here is profits. But it's essential not to only ask how the company is doing today, but to also understand how much untapped demand exists for the product. This is the only way to predict whether a company will be sustainable in the near term, and to make bets on how big the company can get in the future. This is where people get lucky with startups. While skill, diligence, and process drive user growth and product engagement, predicting future markets is notoriously tough. So much so that being smart can actually be a disadvantage. Smart people tend to try to predict future markets by reading industry reports, designing models, and running numbers. However, with access to similar information, people tend to come to similar conclusions. That's why being right isn't enough. Paradoxically, if you are right and everyone agrees with you, competitors will see the opportunity too, enter the market, and eat away at your profits. Therefore, when it comes to monetization over the long term, there's only one way to achieve it. You've got to see a future market others don't. Next, if you can spot the big untapped market on the horizon, you've got to, as Warren Buffett advises, protect it with unbreachable moats. There are only five ways to defend your market from competitors: economy of scale, network effects, regulatory protection, brand, and habit. Without a big unseen market and a way to hold on to it, future profits are no sure thing. Monetization question: are we getting better at capturing the value we create? Monetization metric: profit. A necessary trinity. Growth, engagement, and monetization are interlinked, and each is insufficient on its own. The most highly engaging, habit-forming product will fall if it's only used by a small number of people who pay too little for the service. The overwhelming majority of apps in the App Store are never found by a critical mass, because the companies behind them have failed to find a way to profitably draw users' attention. Similarly, an amazing growth strategy using the latest viral hacks is pointless without a way to retain and profit from the growth. Viddy, the video sharing service and Snapchat predecessor, shocked Silicon Valley in the spring of 2012 by acquiring nearly 3 million users in a month. But shortly after investors plowed $30 million into the company, it became clear the app was a leaky bucket that could not retain its users. Finally, huge market potential is useless without a way to profitably reach and engage customers. For example, music streaming services like Spotify and Pandora are a daily habit for millions of people. But if song owners manage to extract all the value by imposing stricter copyright terms, they have the power to destroy the streaming services. Of course, businesses have to worry about all sorts of other things. See Alex Osterwalder's Business Model Canvas for a more detailed analysis. But thinking through the GEM framework is extremely effective for keeping teams on track. As Thomas Tunguz, a partner at Redpoint Ventures, told me, these three criteria, quote, help to make sure the team is allocating resources correctly, end quote. When it comes to monitoring and regularly communicating what matters, the GEM framework is precious. Thanks for listening. You can find more episodes just like this at tfpodcast.io. We post new episodes every Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday morning. That link will be listed below. Be sure to subscribe to our channels on YouTube and iTunes, or visit us at tfpodcast.io. If you would like to help support our show, we'd really appreciate it. Visit our Patreon and donate. All of those links will be listed below. Again, thanks to Nir Eyal, You can find more of his writing on nearandfar.com. That's nirandfar.com. That link is also listed below. And thank you to our sponsor of today's episode, Presence Media. You can visit them at presencemediadenver.com. That link will also be listed below. Thanks for listening.